The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Silsbee, Texas, weighing in at 412 pounds, the Intercontinental Champion, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Man, listening to the reaction this guy gets from a crowd never gets old. Clearly, this SmackDown crowd can't wait for this one to get started.
Mark Henry's power completely consumes his opponents. When the world's strongest man pulverizes a superstar, it feels like you're being pummeled by five men, and that's if he's in a good mood.
Mark Henry is locked up.
Knocked the breath out with a crushing kick to the gut.
I wouldn't be able to breathe for a week.
Wow, that was a wild strike. Talk about missing the target.
Yeah, it looked like he was completely out of desperation. You know, we've talked about how any of Mark Henry's moves can serve as a finishing move. So how devastating would the move be that Mark Henry chose as his finisher? Just look at his world's strongest slam. I don't think there's a move more punishing or crushing.
Checking out Mark Henry, what can you tell us right now?
Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. We're going to find out who's the better competitor, that's for sure. No gimmicks here, just some good old-fashioned one-on-one action.
This match will have a lot of big moves. One question will be, who will capitalize on those moves the best?
And who will capitalize on those moves the earliest? That's important.
Mark Henry's world's strongest slam takes the term complete destruction to new levels. When Henry brings an opponent down with his monstrous slam, they're not getting up. It's that simple.
Well, there's one word that comes to mind after I see Mark Henry ruin someone with the world's strongest slam. Good night.
Great one-on-one action here tonight. It doesn't get much better than this. If you thought Monday Night Raw was exciting last night, just wait until you see what we have scheduled for tonight. Oh, you can't take many more shots to the face like that.
Yeah, this guy's never gonna look the same. Mark Henry shows us some clever offense here. You know, we used to say Daniel Bryan was one of the most humble superstars the WWE has ever seen. But as his stock has risen, he's become an altogether different kind of competitor. This is a man who now feels there is no one he can't get the better of in the ring. The Flying Goat wrestles with a huge chip on his shoulder.
He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in.
Oh, right to the gut. He's in full-on attack mode now.
Look at the attack here.
Oh, man. Talk about a direct hit.
Daniel Bryan hit that one.
You know, Michael, whatever questions people may have about Daniel Bryan, nobody has ever doubted his toughness or his guts. Hey, the shoulders are down.
Two.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're coming to you live from the Capitol in North Carolina, Raleigh.
There's the yes lock!
Submission locked in, and this might be it.
He's wearing him down with a very effective submission hold.
What diabolical things are going through that mind right now?
When you get in control like this, you want to throw everything at your opponent. And that could be what...
Uh-oh, the bear hug squeezing the life away.
Oh, there's nothing that hurts worse than a good hard bear hug. The shoulders are down.
If you're just tuning in, I'm Michael Cole. Thank you for joining us on this Tuesday evening. Wow, that overhand punch started down behind his feet and just kept coming.
Woo-hoo, man, that came out of left field. Attacking from the top. Wow, he's still down after that. Some air here.
I need some too after sitting next to you. Oh, what a devastating move by Mark Henry.
Two. Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
He lands the strike with great accuracy.
Well, we're on the move here. Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
Seven.
The other deadly aspect of Mark Henry's assault, unmerciful psychological punishment. I've called so many of Daniel Bryan's matches throughout his WWE career, whether I want to admit it or not.
Nearly a kick combo.
Nearly kick combo.
And now Daniel Bryan kicks it up a notch. He may get the three count right there.
Gonna be close.
Man, this is one of those matches you just like to sit back and enjoy watching.
Yeah, one of those you never want to see end.
Uh-oh, here it comes. Daniel Bryan's really getting going in there, and we know what that could mean. Watch out for the
kneeling kick combo.
Kneeling kick combo.
I don't know about you, but Raleigh is...
The shoulders are down!
Two!
What great action we've had in this match.
I'm absolutely loving it, Cole. Come on, aren't you? Look how excited you are. Textbook snapmare. Hey, so effective.
What an assault. This type of attack takes things to a completely different level and leaves your opponent agonizing to breathe.
And momentum turns 180 degrees again.
What a ruthless act. That is not a position you want to be in at any point in this match or ever.
Oh, geez. That'll send your inside scrambling all over the place.
No kidding. This guy's a mess.
He's displaying classic offense here.
Yeah, and that's when he's the most dangerous.
Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
The 400-pounder is fumbling.
That's what I call taking a pounding.
I bet he calls it taking a pounding as well. The shoulders are down. Man, he's got to feel great. You want to talk about... Oh, what a spectacle.
Oh, there were some...
Let's take a look back at weddings.
Here's your winner, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Guys, that was a big win for him right there.
Whoa. I think he just put the entire WWE roster on notice with that victory.
Join us next week on WWE SmackDown.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring. From St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 245 pounds, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, the Apex Predator, Randy Orton.
Well, this superstar has all the tools needed to win this one. Now let's see if he can put them together.
You can feel the electricity in the air from this sold-out Raleigh crowd.
And approaching the ring, from Perry, Oklahoma, weighing in at 275 pounds, he is a real American, Jack Swagger.
You know, sometimes a superstar just has that look in his eye, and this is one of those times.
You can feel the electricity in the air from this sold-out Raleigh crowd. We've seen Jack Swagger be responsible for some of the most heinous assaults in his business. The Real American possesses a lethal arsenal with power moves, suplexes, and crippling submissions. Strikes like that can end this one in a hurry.
Uh-oh. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Well, on the topic of Randy Orton here, tell us your thoughts.
The name Orton and the word history go hand in hand. I think about WrestleMania 20, when Randy made his WrestleMania debut in the same building his dad did for the first Showcase of Immortals back in 1985. At WrestleMania 20, Randy scored the pinfall for his team that night and gave a glimpse of the WrestleMania greatness that was to come.
Well, luckily, the body hasn't absorbed too much of an attack up to this point.
Look at him unloading with the Dez press.
That was a shot with the intent of taking Jack Swagger out.
Cole, it doesn't get more direct than that. Jack Swagger definitely looks worse for wear after that one.
Oh, the reversal by Jack Swagger.
Oh, out of nowhere.
Jerry, you talked before about Randy Orton's WrestleMania debut.
Yes, sir.
Even Orton himself, with all of his arrogance and cold-blooded demeanor, will admit it was special for him to be in New York City for his WrestleMania debut. Regardless of if you like Randy Orton or not, we certainly witnessed history in the making.
Well, Michael, seeing Randy Orton at WrestleMania 20 was special, and it was indeed historic. His dad, Cowboy Bob, was one of the most hated villains at the first WrestleMania in 1985. And when you quick pin, hey, is this it?
It may be. And he kicks out.
And he lives to fight again. Don't let Jack catch his breath here. Get back on him. Whoa, that was some reversal by Swagger.
Putting some power on display with that takedown.
It is so hard to stop that kind of strength.
Nice reversal by Orton.
Yeah, that's because he saw that one coming a mile away. Jack Swagger has found an answer here. Okay, the question on my mind is, how do you beat a man like Randy Orton? I mean, he is such a veteran of the sport. Simply trying to convince yourself this will be an easy match is not even close to enough. All I'm saying is, his opponent needs a plan. Jack Swagger taking advantage right now. Oh, no. Wait a minute, Cole. What's he going to do here? Where did this explosion of offense come from? Not today. Too fast. To avoid that. Oh, that's one way to make your lunch come back up.
I think when you look at Randy Orton, being that he is a veteran in the ring, doesn't mean he is without weaknesses. The problem is, once they're exposed, they rarely resurface. But first things for covers.
And the shoulder's up in time.
Well, as long as it's up before that three count, that's all that matters.
And for Randy Orton, now more than ever, it's gut check time.
The Viper slithers out of the way.
Oh, slithers. I see what you did there, Cole. Very clever.
You better look out. Here comes Randy Orton. His moves are so crisp, so devastating, and no wasted movement.
We're looking at complete domination here.
Not today. Too fast.
Uh-oh. The running front chop block. The end is near.
Ooh, that had to hurt. You can bet that the crowd knows the history of Randy Orton. The shoulders are down.
Two.
And it's up. He got the shoulder up.
I have no idea. I have no idea how Randy Orton kicked out of that.
Here we go. Jack Swagger setting it up. There she be, the gut wrench.
I love to see a good gut wrench.
Looking for the quick pin.
I don't think even the referee would.
Oh, look at that. He managed to get a shoulder up.
Well, like they say, Cole, timing is everything. The Viper slithers out of that pinning predicament.
Can WWE fans have heard the name Orton ring through arenas for more than 50 years? When it comes to the Apex Predator, it doesn't get much more sadistic than Randy Orton and the people with us live at WWE events, and those watching at home know it.
Well, the fans certainly know where Randy Orton came from. A third-generation superstar, grandson of the Big O.
That's got to be it, Randy Orton. How about that finishing move?
Look how slow he is to recover here. That was some. The shoulders are down.
And he gets into the ropes.
These superstars looking for a victory, looking to build momentum.
You're right about that. Momentum is so important in a match like this.
Oh no, Randy Orton looking to finish it.
You know, if the WWE fans know one thing.
No way! What a move from Randy Orton. That's how you impress the WWE Universe, folks. Looking motivated now.
Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects.
You can see him struggling to stand after all the damage he's taken.
That packed a punch.
Well, we're on the move here. It's going to take a lot to change the tide of this one. Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
King, you talked about the fans and Randy Orton, and let me tell you, Randy Orton doesn't give two, quote, you know what's about the fans. You did say something I do agree with, however. With every step the Viper takes in his way to the ring, he is plotting. Orton is planning, and he is devising ways to unleash his assault on an opponent. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
And he brings the action back inside the ring.
Yeah, I think this is good strategy.
How much damage did that do?
A lot from the looks of it.
Eight.
I just can't get over the physicality of this match. This has been brutal.
Brutal and very, very painful for these guys.
Makes the cover. Both of these competitors have so much resolve, it's going to take a minor miracle to keep one of them down. Back down to earth with authority.
What an impact. That was thunderous. Talk about feeling something through the entire arena.
And he just found out that's not the place you want to be.
Not ever, never.
Added insult to potential injury there.
Like I said, those moves don't win the match in one go, but they add up. And boy, have they added up in this one. There are few better. Oh, wait, nice reversal. What's going to happen now?
That's like watching someone being manhandled. What force.
No kidding, what a slam. All these power moves tonight are making bigger and bigger impacts. Oh, out of nowhere.
That shoulder's being torn apart. This is a ruthless attack.
Have you ever had your shoulder torn apart, Cole?
No.
Check that out. That's how effective offense can be when you're able to combine moves together.
These guys are giving it absolutely everything they've got.
They're not holding anything back, and I love it. Hey, nice move.
What an assault. This type of attack takes things to a completely different level and leaves your opponent agonizing to breathe.
Oh, he's in trouble now. Not this.
He's looking at it again.
Jack Swagger, what a crafty maneuver.
Now that's a finishing move.
The shoulders are down.
Two.
These guys giving this sold-out crowd exactly what they came to see.
What an incredible match.
This might be big.
What a hellaciously physical match these gladiators have put themselves through. The intensity of this has been incredible. He could pin his opponent right here.
I think this is it.
This has been a war.
You're right about that, Cole. This has been one of the most physical battles I've witnessed in a long, long time.
If this continues, we could be talking about something no one wants to discuss. Facial reconstructive surgery.
I know you don't like to talk about your facial reconstructive surgery.
Oh, I think this man means business.
Randy Orton with some strong moves currently.
He's delivering an old-fashioned butt kicking right here.
He's going for it again. Astonishing maneuver by Randy Orton. Oh boy, Jack Swagger has blood flowing. I think it's gut check time now. Whoa, that was some reversal by Swagger. Oh! Ow! Ooh.
That's vicious. Cutting off oxygen inflicts serious damage to an opponent. Hey, you could have until the referee's five count to break it. Use it.
Imagine what he's feeling, being deliberately deprived of oxygen by an opponent during a match. This is almost insufferable.
No kidding, this is getting vicious. Not a lot of spring left in his step right now. Hey, the shoulders are down.
I can't believe everything that's transpired thus far. It's been so physical.
You're right about that, Cole. This has been an all-out war.
The quick reversal there by Randy Orton.
Ah! The Viper strikes. RKO.
There's the finish.
Could this be it?
I think so.
Here's your winner, the Apex Predator, Randy Orton.
It wasn't pretty, but a win's a win.
I don't make the matches, but if I did, I'd put these two back in the ring ASAP. What an amazing match.
What a night for SmackDown. This will send shockwaves through the entire WWE.
I know I'm shocked. Good night, everybody.
What a match these two put on. Randy Orton and Jack Swagger just going full at it. Randy Orton with the RKO though and the victory. But after the match, Seth Rollins comes down with a chair. Hits Randy Orton repeatedly over and over and over and over again and says, this is what's going to happen at King of the Ring. Because our match is going to be no holds barred. No rules. No stipulations. I'm just going to beat you, and then I will beat you. The words from Seth Rollins there. And earlier in the night, it was Dean Ambrose that was victorious of a Bad News Bears. Bad News Bears' hot streak has now come to an end. And it's Dean Ambrose who will now join Cesaro, Bray Wyatt, Kofi Kingston, Ryback, Curtis Axel, Finn Balor, and Kevin Owens in the King of the Ring tournament, which will start on Monday Night Raw. I've been Shelton92G, and thanks for watching.